Good morning. Yeah, Pickers family, I would like to welcome you this morning. Thank you for coming. I pray that you would continue to support the family as well in the next days and weeks as they go through this time in their lives that is brand new to them. Familiar reading, the passing of a loved one comes from the book of Ecclesiastes. That seems particularly fitting considering Richard's love of the outdoors and how many pails of rainwater he carried to his trees that he was so very proud of. Solomon writes, there is a time for everything and a season for every activity under heaven. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to embrace and a time to refrain. God has made everything beautiful in his time. He also set eternity in the hearts of men, yet they cannot fathom what God has done from beginning to end. I know there is nothing better for men than to be happy and do good while they live, and everyone may eat and drink and find satisfaction in all his toil. This is the gift of God. Know that everything God does will endure forever. Nothing can be added to it, nothing taken from it. God does it so that men will revere him. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for Richard, for the family and friends you blessed him with, a man who truly found satisfaction in all of his toil. Lord, as we gather to celebrate his life, we welcome your presence and from your holy word, the truth that everything you do will endure forever. Nothing can be added to it, nothing taken from it. God does it so that men will revere him. And Father, we come to you today lifting our voices in praise and worship and adoration. To Jesus I pray, amen. Scripture the family has chosen for today is the 23rd Psalm. David writes, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures, he leads me beside the quiet waters, he restores my soul. He guides me in paths of righteousness for his namesake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Truly goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And again we pray, Father, we thank you for guiding us in the path of righteousness, for the promise that as we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you are walking with us because of our relationship with your precious Son, Jesus. Father, thank you for the gift of salvation and for your amazing grace. Through Jesus I pray, amen. We now get to listen to Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone. Thank you. amazing grace. You allow his grace to wash over your heart and set you free and take off your chains. I must say, this community supports one another very nicely. I've been a chaplain at Heart of America for 8 years. I've been to a lot of funerals here, and this is the first time I actually got in the church instead of the overflow. So I guess it pays to get invited to preach. When I moved to North Dakota, I was very surprised to learn that we produce some 30 million pounds of honey each year, making us the number one state in the nation. Seriously, an industry that requires pretty little flowers and tiny little insects thriving in the state, where people talk about hoping that summer falls on a weekend again this year. Then I met Richard and Alice and saw firsthand how hard men and women work to accomplish that task, that made a lot more sense. I'm sure you've all heard the story about how they first met when she tripped Richard at the roller rink. I think the second encounter was even sweeter, when that handsome soldier showed up at her farm while she was unharnessing the team of horses. Alice got so nervous that she forgot to take all of the parts off on the horse and ended up trying to drag one of the workhorses in the barn backwards. I'm thinking the smile on Richard's face then was similar to that smile a couple of months ago when the family was teasing him about collecting every empty container he could find, including prescription bottles and whatever else he could get the lid off his stuff full of some little item. As they were teasing him, I said, "Richard, by the way, I'm looking for a 9mm bolt about 2 inches long." And then with that smile, without even missing a beat, he said, "Did you want that in fine thread or coarse?" We're going to hear a song in just a little bit that Alice pointed out reminded us what a good man Richard is and was. Richard was the kind of man who did what he said he would do. He didn't leave a job until it was through. As we heard last night, it might have been a 15-minute job that could take 12 hours. Even though he sold a business, honey was his job until the end. Just for fun, I checked, and the word honey, and that Alice is nudging, and the word honey is in the Bible actually 59 times. Many of the references are similar to Genesis 43:11. Put some of the best products of the land in your bags. Take them down to the man as a gift, a little balm, a little honey, some spices and myrrh, some pistachio nuts and almonds. The best products of the land. Well, the dietary advice from Proverbs 24:13, "Eat honey, my son, for it is good. Honey from the comb is sweet to your taste." As the song continues, he taught us kids to do our best at home and work and school. It was something that we accepted as a rule. He took his advice and had that teaspoon of honey every morning, along with his avocado and a Honeycrisp apple. He had his routines that he followed. His love of flying was always evident during our conversations. And most seniors were learning how to drive golf carts. Richard was riding Harleys. When some thought he should have been on a golf cart, he actually was on the ladder, making sure that his rainwater collection system was going to be ready when the season was there. Had to keep those trees happy. Richard was a man of wisdom. It was fun to see him tease and teach his family, always again with that gentle spirit. Sort of like Solomon wrote in 25:27, "It's not good to eat too much honey, nor is it honorable to eat to seek one's own honor, nor is it honorable to seek one's own honor." Getting back to that song, another verse, I look back at Daddy as a rule. He'd be the first to give someone a second chance. You heard again last night how many people's lives he impacted. 90 years. He'd be the first to give him a second chance. Much like King David wrote in the psalm that we read, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." When we are content in our relationship with the Lord, when we have peace deep in our hearts, it's easy to be a friend, it's easy to make friends. In our conversation, I learned a lot about the motorhome gang and the wonderful circle of friends that they made around the nation. How they learned to love and to help and depend and encourage one another as they traveled across this beautiful land of Southern Pine. As the leaves started turning this last fall, Richard's thoughts turned to Texas and the urge to travel had him restless. But Texas was not to be his this year. Rather, the true land of milk and honey that awaits all of us who are walking with Jesus on this journey. And the majesty and the beauty of heaven and the joy of worshiping God around the throne. So much better than a Harley ride across the Lone Star State. We have promises of green pastures and still waters and a soul that has been restored for eternity. We will have truth, true righteousness before our Father in heaven. Richard had a pretty tough last chapter here on earth, but David promised to go and walk in the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. And we can know that we do not walk through these trying times alone. We do not serve a God who waits on the other side of our deep valleys of despair and discouragement, waiting for us to come up the other side. We serve a God who sent his son Jesus to walk alongside us through these trying times as he was walking alongside Richard and as he is walking alongside the family now, again, as they learn to live in this brand new chapter of life as we grieve. We also know that God is preparing a table before me that will surely include honey, that he will anoint our heads with oil, that our cup will run it over. When we have the Lord as our shepherd, we can say what David said here in the last verse of Psalm 23, "Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." In heaven, we can know that our enemies have been defeated. There will be no more trials, no more death, no more sickness. Best of all, no more sin, that we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And you say with confidence that the Lord is my shepherd. If not, and he is still calling on people to repent. 2 Peter 3:9, the Lord is not slow in keeping his promises, as some understand slowness. He is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance. And David writes in Psalm 119, starting at 102, "I have not departed from your law, for you yourself have taught me. How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. I gain understanding from your precepts, therefore I hate every wrong path. Your word is a lamp to my feet, and a light to my path. I have taken an oath and confirmed it that I will follow your righteous law." And as the song continued, as a rule, he was a guide that I can go by. As a rule, he never lied, and now I know why. Thank you.
Thank you.
fall asleep or to grieve like the rest of men who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, so we believe that God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep in him. According to the Lord's own words, and we tell you that you who are still alive, who are left to the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, with the call of trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, as Paul wrote, encourage each other with these words. You're invited to join us for a luncheon immediately following the service. Some good fellowship time. As you know, the burial will take place in the spring. But for today, let's pray a blessing over the food and close our service. Father, we thank you for the many hands that have worked hard to prepare this food. We ask your blessings over it to nourish the nourishment of our bodies. We also ask that you would bless our time of fellowship and remember a very good man. Father, I just pray for an anointing on his family today. Lord, I pray you would hold Alice so close that she could feel your love and embrace and bless the kids and the grandkids and the great-grandkids. Lord, help them to remember this special day of celebration of a good man that went into eternity. For now, we commit the body of our loved one and friend to be laid to rest until God calls it to resurrection. Lord, may your spirit touch each saddened heart here today. Give them the strength to carry on for your glory forever and ever. Amen.